Hey Cafe crew, Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you 5 tips in Lightroom for editing photos. So tip number 1, I'm sure you're aware that we start doing all our adjustments right here inside the basic panel. But what you might not know is all of these are in the histogram, so we can actually just click and drag around into different regions. So we do our shadows, we can do our highlight recovery right there, and I'm just dragging in the histogram. Let's set our midtones. And of course we can do our shadows. Let's drag that to the left to darken it, and the whites. So you can see that just by dragging around in the histogram, we can do all our adjustments. And there we go, before and after. Tip number 2, revealing clipping in the shadows and highlights while we're working. Okay, let's adjust our exposure and highlights here just to give it a little bit more information. We want to make this flare work. So what I do is if I hold down the Alt key or the Option key, as I drag out, I can start to see where that highlight clips. So I can take it nice and bright, same thing with the shadow. Hold the Alt or the Option, go down on the blacks, and you can see there, that's where the clipping or the loss of detail starts. You can have a little bit there, it's not gonna hurt. So let's open up our exposure a little bit. Once again, check out whites, and we can get those exactly where we want by holding down that Alt Option key. So there's before, after. Tip number 3. We want to darken the sky in the subject, so we're going to grab the gradient tool, maybe recover the highlights, pull the exposure down a little bit, and drag it down. Now look what happens. It covers up the rock, and we want to bring it back. Go to the brush. A lot of people are not aware it's there. And then if we hit the Alt or the Option key, we now go into erase mode. And notice I've turned on auto mask. That'll protect our edges, and I can just go around there now and just paint that back how it was. Take off auto mask and just paint in the middle here to make sure there's not any kind of weirdness going on. Tip number 4, working with black and white. I'm sure you're already aware that you can click on black and white here and that will convert it to black and white, and you can play around with these colors. But did you know if you go up to the basic, you can make some big changes by changing the temperature. Look at this, see that? And also the tint. So it's a good idea to start there, then go into the black and white, and then just do some little bit of tweak in there. And see how those blues really get affected by that slider? You can just tune those up exactly how you want them. Tip number 5. All right, so when you're doing some really detailed work, such as some detailed dodging and burning like we're actually doing in here, sometimes things can slow down a little bit. So this is a performance tip. There's 2 things you can do for performance. If you go up under the Lightroom preferences, you'll notice that we can turn on or off your GPU. In this case, I'm using it. It's giving me more acceleration. Sometimes it will slow you down. So try both ways. And then the other thing is if we choose use smart previews instead of originals for image editing, what it will do is it will create a smaller file, a lossy DNG, for you to do the editing. But it's also going to apply it to your real photo. So it just speeds up the editing. And to just click on here, you can create that smart preview. All right, guys, there we go. There's 5 tips inside of Lightroom. So don't forget to hit that subscribe button, become part of the Cafe crew, get a new tutorial every single week. If you like this, smash the like button into dust, add a comment. What's your favorite Lightroom tip? Let's get a discussion going. Don't forget to check out my other video that I made with 7 Lightroom tips. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.